I will be talking about photofission of uranium by using a clinical linac. Few motivations. First one is from my personal motivation. I was theory in Oxford University, and I returned Turkey, and you know, I looked at there is no experimental study at the universities for nuclear. Therefore, I wanted to do experiments in Turkey. This is why my personal motivation. Second one is there is no dedicated research accelerators in developing world, actually, countries. Kirk yesterday, I mean, pointed out that 1 out of 6 people live in developed countries. The rest, almost 90% of the world, is living in the developing countries. Developing means, I mean, there are countries who are trying to be developed, and there are countries, I mean, without development, and also some countries, I mean, they don't even know what development is. Therefore, such medical linacs are very important for the peaceful use of nuclear in developing countries. This is an example. This is the first study conducted by a medical linac, which is not proper linac, not dedicated for the research, used for the cancer treatment, but every 5 years in the hospitals in general, they are replaced by a new one, and the old one is thrown to bin. Therefore, what they have shown here is, I mean, just donated to engineering or physics department and use the students for research. Therefore, there is one advantage of, there are many advantages, I will tell, but one of the advantages of having really good total photon flux. I mean, you have a 40 by 40 almost, a plane with very uniform, very homogeneous flux. Therefore, you can do many things there, starting from the archaeology to material hardening, material modifications, to even seed irradiation for the mutation. Also, you can do fundamental nuclear science, applications of nuclear techniques for peaceful use of nuclear. And also, this is very important, training and education of students, actually, because many of the students, I mean, in my country, I know that many people come Europe or United States to get a PhD. They run experiments. Even in, at CERN, we are a member of, partial member of CERN. They come and run experiments, but without even knowing the instrumentation or data analysis. Therefore, this is very good for training for the developing countries. I will just briefly, here the outline is, and let's start with, this is the chart of nuclei, stable ones, value of stability. And in Europe, or in the developed countries, let's say, accelerators have very high flux and very high energies. Therefore, there is here, the research is going on here, what is called exotic nuclei or halo nuclei for the fundamental nuclear science. And there are new magic numbers here, not the old ones, but there are new magic numbers and very large nuclear matter, I mean, they create. Therefore, I mean, while they go to very high energies, I mean, one example is CERN, but there are still interesting research for low energy charge particle and photon reactions, such as giant dipole resonance, pygmy resonance, modes of nuclei, etc. I will briefly show you what the nuclear, photonuclear reactions we conduct. We have projectile, we have target, and you know this, what happens here is the photon comes, hits the target, we create a hot nucleus, it decays either, you know, neutrons or, you know, gammas or beta minus, beta plus possible, and we have a stable nuclei. Now, An example is, for example, here, I mean, if you take, I can't read it at the moment, but like gallium, for example, if you knock out a neutron, you get here either zinc or even the copper by alpha knockout. Therefore, it's possible to knock out either neutron, protons, and you observe beta minus beta plus decays or even the alpha knockout and create a metastable nuclei. Just an example, or just before I go there, just the properties of this linac. This is a medical linac. It's a very compact design. We have basically 50 kV electrons generated. The 3 gigahertz radio frequency, and we have it's pulsed, of course, with 30 microampere flux. This is the shape. Of course, I mean, we learned a lot from here, even starting from the maintenance to, you know, running experiments. This is okay. We get the electrons here, tungsten filament. Hit the tungsten and we get the bremsstrahlung here. Therefore, the distribution of flux is exactly at something like 50 centimeters. It's very flat. Therefore, what I mean is when you have almost 40 by 40, you have an excellent flux for irradiation. I mean, it is very uniform, it is very homogeneous. Now this is the spectrum of bremsstrahlung for 18 MeV, but we were able to modify it to get 25 MeV electrons. That is quite enough for nuclear experiments. We also, for the measurements of the residuals, we need to have detectors. The type of detectors, high purity germanium or scintillators we have. And you know, we do all these calibrations. Instrumentation in the data acquisition. Just an example to show whether our work is in agreement with the literature. We took, for example, gallium. We knocked out a neutron through beta plus decay. We observed the 68 zinc. Same as for alpha knockout, we observed the 67 zinc or even the germanium. From gallium to germanium via beta minus. And these energy levels are excellently defined, well determined, and the results are very good agreement with the literature. Even for proton-rich nuclei, the results are even better than more complicated, well-dedicated laboratories in the world. This is a sample spectrum. And these are results. I mean, you see for gallium, we determine the energy levels from excited states to ground state. And the results, I mean, while these results are ours, these are the literature, and they are all perfectly good agreement with the literature for all experiments. These are just quickly I am showing. Also, some other nuclei such as praseodymium, we obtain the same. All these decays and energy levels are perfectly defined, even better than the literature. Also, we were able to determine the half-lives of the residuals. I don't give the details because it is a little bit irrelevant, but I would like to show that the system is working perfectly. After having done this, photonuclear reactions, neutron, proton knockouts, alpha knockouts, I mean, we had enough background and experience. Then I got this laboratory donated from a chemist, a retired chemist. I mean, apparently he stored everything. He didn't throw anything. I mean, now I am becoming like him, but while we are cleaning the laboratory, I mean, we found a box. And it is on the box, it's empty actually. It's written, you know, uranium oxide. So, you know, we opened it and, you know, we scratched some. Few milligrams of uranium actually. I mean, probably it was from 60s or 70s or 80s, I don't know. Therefore, we had this. We have linac, you know, as I said, we have detectors, we have also software. Then we irradiated the uranium we found from this old fellow. Therefore, what we did is to perform photofission of target. Then we prepared the appropriate geometry for the radiation. You see, we have a plane like we can't attenuate or focus. Therefore, we have a plane 40 by 40 everywhere. We know that uniform bremsstrahlung we have. The change is 4 to 18 MeV. Therefore, we prepared the geometry. Then the target was irradiated for 1 hour with 18 MeV bremsstrahlung photons obtained from this clinical linac. Fission yield data resulted from photonuclear reaction were counted for 2 days. This is an offline experiment. Be careful. I mean, this is not online because the system is not designed. It's not proper linac for the nuclear experiment, but this is a proper linac. Then the spectrum was analyzed to identify the photofission yields. The energy and area of the each peak and half-lives of the nuclei of the peaks were determined. And this is the peak that we got. I mean, we had thousands of peaks, residual nucleus, through this photofission. And we are not well experienced. I mean, therefore we had to move to root program of, you know, the CERN to analyze the data. We determine certain peaks, and these are very clean spectrum actually for the fission. And these are the determined one of for my PhD student. I mean, she did this analysis from tellur to xenon, or even the technetium, and the results again are perfectly in agreement with the literature. And it is therefore, as a conclusion, I will just say summary and outlook. I mean, in Turkey, we didn't have a proper linac for research, whereas we had over 300 electron linacs for medical treatment. Therefore, this study is, as we did, you know, many papers, published many papers, and I am trying to promote this because, you know, every 5 years, these medical linacs are thrown to bin. I mean, just, you know, packed it. Therefore, this is important to underline that one can use such linacs in the developing countries for the peaceful uses of nuclear, and as well as for the training of the students before they come to more advanced laboratory such as the ones in Europe. Therefore, it is a unique research center what we have now in Turkey, a small group, of course, performing spectroscopy and instrumentation. That's important to promote nuclear science in developing countries, training and education facility for the PhD and master's students. For the case, I mean, of Turkey, CERN membership, nuclear and high energy physics studies. It's important to teach students that this. We do have applications from material hardening to, you know, test of many, many detectors like AGATA to, you know, LIMPs, some lanthanum bromide detectors. It is also interesting to have this very succinct, very concrete science program we have, because in Europe you can't find a dedicated linac of 25 MeV for low energy photon reactions. These are all high energies. Therefore, we have an island there. We do many publications, we do many applications, many theses, etc. Therefore, particularly for pygmy and giant dipole resonance regions are very important. If we could move to online measurements, not the offline, but online measurements, then we will be a center of nuclear NRF studies, actually, resonance fluorescence. Energy levels and half-life measurements for particularly proton-rich nuclei, these are better than literature. And the applications of nuclear techniques from archaeology to engineering, you know, for the developing countries are very important. It's interesting that, I mean, I was surprised because this is the first photonuclear paper of Turkey, homemade. I mean, in 2011 or something, I mean, 2015. That's very surprising. Turkey is so developed country, actually, so rich country. There are so many, you know, facilities, but unfortunately we don't have a proper linac dedicated for the nuclear research. That's why, I mean, this is, for me, I'm proud of. Also, I would like to underline the Turkish Science Foundation. I mean, it is really good, benefits to work in Turkey. I mean, I am living in Antalya. Antalya is like, after Istanbul, is one of the best places. I have many postdocs and research visitors from Europe, United States, even India, Pakistan, Russia. In my group, there are many people visiting us. I mean, they pay really good money, I mean, compared to living cost of Turkey. It's very good money. And also they cover the trips also. This will be very also important to say that all students are also financed to come here by TÜBİTAK to carry on their PhD or master program. Okay, I would like to thank you very much for listening. As I pointed out, I mean, the reason I am here is to, you know, get to know the community and try to do what to do, actually, in the future. Also, thank you, the organizers, for giving me this opportunity to introduce my group, all contribution to the experimental studies of Turkey. Thank you very much for listening.